brilliant brains, Roxy Robinson wouldn't even get wet. In all of New York, they didn't come much dumber than Roxy the Weasel. To be frank, Roxy was a dope. Dumb as Roxy was, he could smell trouble like other people could smell gas. But he should never have taken that blind alley by the side of Prieto's bakery.
Your name Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Roxy Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Also known as Roxy the Weasel?
Uh-huh.
The same Roxy the Weasel who helps with Fat Sam?
Uh-huh.
Whatever game it was everyone was playing, sure as eggs is eggs, Roxy the Weasel had been scrambled. Flash Frankie, the best lawyer in New York. Sure, he's a little shady, but he's the best, believe me. Flash Frankie's silver tongue can get a guy out of jail quicker than a truckload of dynamite. Something kind of fishy's going on here. To be perfectly honest, I'm beginning to wonder what's going on myself. I mean, the play's only just started and already the stage is full of stiffs. Oh yeah, by the way, you've probably wondered who I am. The name's Malone. Bugsy Malone.
He's a sinner. Seems to be alone, but they love him, Bugsy Malone. City slicker, he can charm you with a smile and a style all of his own. Everybody loves that man, Bugsy Malone.
with an Italian mother and an Irish father. I naturally grew up a little confused. I didn't see much future as a spaghetti waiter at Mamalu Jeans or pushing pen at City Hall. So I drifted from this to that, you know, walking the line, trying hard not to fall inside. That is, until the night I walked into here, Huff Becker's bookstore. Pleased to meet you. I'm Bugsy Malone. You a dancer. A singer, right? Oh, a baseball player.
Zip it, Wisey. I ain't in the mood for conversation.
You don't like me?
Listen, I'm just surprised you don't stoop all that gun on each other's. Honey, go in now. If she's here about the audition, Bugsy, she's gone a long way. Every day they tell me to come back tomorrow.
Now, I bet you're wondering what kind of crazy place this is. I mean, with people disappearing into bookcases. Well, firstly, this neighborhood ain't for dum-dums. And between yours and me, this bookstore just ain't no bookstore. This is Fat Sam's place. Fat Sam's Grand Slam, the liveliest joint in town.
Thank you.
son, Robert Robinson, known to the police as Roxy the Weasel, believed to be a member of the gang of the alleged mob to the king, Fat Sam's the Shadow. Robinson was the victim of a sensational incident, and we go straight over to our reporter on the spot for a...
So tell me, how you allow this to happen? Roxy was one of my best. What do you have to say for yourself, you bunch of dummies? Knuckles, Louie, Ritzy, Snake Eyes, Angelo, you're a disgrace to your profession, do you hear me? A disgrace. And most of all, you're a disgrace to me, Fat Sam. We all know who's behind this, don't we?
Sure, boss.
You don't need a hat full of brains and all that, do you?
Certainly not, boss.
We all know who's been monkeying us around, don't we?
Sure do, boss.
So is it then, you dummies? Come on, tell me, you dummies.
Mr. Sam, how about
my
audition, Mr. Sam?
Am I going mad? Am I just playing tricks on me? Will you come back tomorrow, Fizzy?
But yesterday you said tomorrow, boss.
Fizzy, will you get out of here?
You okay, boss?
Be careful, boss. You break something.
Break something? Sure I'll break something, Snake. I'll break your damn neck. Dancers, dancers, I'm surrounded by namby-pamby dancers, singers, piano players, tin whistle players, banjo players. And a time when I need brains, do you hear me? Brains! Brains and muscles! Now pour me a drink, Knuckles. You! You great hunk of lava! Trouble is you got brains where you don't have muscles. I tell you, my pecuniary's got more muscles than you. So what's funny?
Donuts
and a Coke with two straws.
Gunnery! Sorry, boss.
You're not sick, though.
Now this is enough.
Yeah. Anyone who Next!
Can I have the balls back, please?
Next!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am the great Mad Beanie. From this hat, I will produce not a one, right? Not a two, right? But a three rabbit.
Next! Don't give up your day job.
I wish they'd hurry up. I get really nervous waiting.
Quit worrying, will you?
I meant to be counting on this many people.
This bunch are all conjurers and magicians by the look of it. We've got no competition, believe me.
How do I look?
You look great.
I look a wreck. Hello, everybody.
So how are you, Clarence?
Don't ask. I suppose you're wondering why I'm here.
You bet. Next!
What's the meaning? Don't you like us? Don't you know who we are?
Lousy Brown, singer.
The light, honey.
Sorry, Mr. DeVoe?
Step into the light, honey. This show isn't set in a mine shaft.
Lousy Brown, singer.
Oscar! Oscar! I'm back! I get one more chance! This is not for good! Hit me, Oscar! Out! 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 Okay, honey. Be back to Iowa. This show's got to stop back. Lena's come home. Hit it, Joe!
Fat Sam's place.
He won't see me.
I'll talk to him.
You know him?
Know him? We're like that.
You're really good friends?
No, not exactly. It's just, when I talk to him, I cross my fingers that he won't hit me.
Widely used by Mark the Gang. We interrupt our interruption to go straight over to our reporter, Steve O'School, who is on the spot at the latest verging.
Okay! Ah! Question! Have you looked into the storage yet?
No comment.
Have you looked into the storage yet?
No comment.
Captain Smolsky, is it true the guns are being used by only one gang?
No comment.
I think keep a strong on our sandwich, Chief.
No comment. Okay, get out of here. Look, we know there were five guys here. What else did you see?
Nothing. I see nothing.
You must have seen something.
Nothing. My name is Mr. Cobb. I see nothing. I play my piano. I mind my own business. I come on a boat just this year. I have papers. I need government overcoat.
Get out of here.
Captain, I found something.
What is it, Archery?
It's a brush, Captain.
No. What have you found?
A gun, Captain.
What kind of gun?
A big gun, Captain.
Knucklehead, I send you on a 6-month fingerprint course, and all you can tell me is that it's a big gun. You noble great Irish stew pot!
As you've probably gathered, Schmolsky and Audrey have about as much chance of solving this case than I have been president of the United States. I mean, apart from the subway home, the only thing Schmolsky ever caught is Asian blue. Meanwhile, back to our story. Bad Sam's definitely getting a little nervous. I mean, if you had a gang of dumbums like this to rely on, you'd be nervous.
Outsmarted by that lounge lizard, right?
Right, boss.
And we're getting right back on top, right?
Right back on top, boss.
We're going to kick that drugstore cowboy right back into line, right?
You bet, boss.
Sure, we've been a little slow off the start. But when it comes to the crunch, no dumb bums we ain't.
No dumb bums we ain't.
Louie, I'm going to tell you all where we're going wrong. Louie, standing against the wall.
Who? Me, boss?
Are you Shakedown Louie?
Yeah, boss.
The same Shakedown Louie that used to be Harvey Spleen Dick up before I gave you the name Shakedown Louie?
Yeah, boss.
Then stand against the wall, you parrot's brain. And you, Rinsy, hand me a pie, now.
Pie, boss? What I do wrong, boss? Talk to me, boss.
You did nothing, Louie. Nothing. Okay, Louie, you can sit down now. Miss. That's the root of our troubles. We're behind the times.
I don't get it, boss.
We ain't never gonna get on top of this kind of hardware knuckles. It's old fashioned, obsolete, defunct. In short, gotta get ourselves that gun. Hello?
Hello, Sam?
Yes, stop, Gavin.
I'll kick the gun.
Spill, Shady, spill.
You know I'm pushing laundry?
On East Boarding Street?
That's it. Second floor. Behind the laundry.
This is very good news. I'll see you're okay. Good boy. I'll be sending my voice right away. You know the Hung Fu Shin Laundry? Get going there. That's where the guns are. Knock you knuckles, you dumb bug. You stay here with me.
Good work, Shady. You're on your money.
Thanks, Captain.
Sam's boys have a quiet pod. Get out of here. Shoulders, if there's one thing I can't abide, it's a too tiny canal.
Boss, he's busy, lady. Come back tomorrow.
No, wait, honey, wait. I'll be right there, 5 minutes. Go powder your nose or something. Make yourself comfortable. Acting normal means acting normal, right?
Right, boss.
So act normal. That way they don't know we're scared to death. I don't mean scared to death. I mean a little concerned. And right now, I'm going to buy ourselves some time. Thinking time. I'm going to send someone to help us out of our little predicament. No tension, though, you hear me? Specialist.
A doctor, boss?
Not a doctor, you filbury! A whole love!
Well, I thought we was Ugin's boss.
Not a dumb bum. This guy's a real McCoy.
Looney Bugonzi?
The very same office trolley matters a hat of Looney Bugonzi. The best man in Chicago. Right, here's what we do. We arrange ourselves a meeting with Danny Dan. Bugonzi will be in the back of the car next to me. And Knuckles, you knucklehead, you drive.
Right. Well, I don't drive, boss.
What? You don't drive? You matzohead! Come on, Dan, answer this damn phone. Don't drive? Then we gotta get ourselves a driver.
Hello?
Oh, hello, is that Danny Dan's residence?
Yeah, who is it?
Sam Pichetto. Don't worry, lady, you'll know who I am.
Hello? Hi, Sam. What can I do for you?
I want to meet you, Dan, to do a little talking.
Where?
Eastchester Park, 5 ways of Denver and Luxburg. You hearing me?
Yeah, I'm hearing you, Sam. But you come along. No hood's mine.
No hood's Dan. You have my word. What's he talking about? Don't bring any hood. He's wiped out on my hood. Just you and me and our drivers. Agreed?
Agreed. Got him, the knucklehead.
Got him, the salami.
In my motor.
Bugsy, give a girl a break.
Are you sure you got the right guy?
Oh, you're not like all those other saps.
No?
You got lovely blue eyes.
There'll be lovely black eyes if that sand catches us.
Come on, sugar. How about smear my lipstick?
Tallulah, I'm warning you. Come any closer and I'll call my lawyer.
So call him.
Hi, Blousy. I was looking for you.
Knuckles, that board ready for our audition yet?
Ready, boss. The board's ready for audition.
Okay, honey. I'm all ears. $200 for driving a milk truck, now do you, Bugsy?
Okay, you just got yourself a driver.
Good boy, good boy. Knuckles, fix me a drink, now! Things are shaping up real fine, Bugsy, and I'm getting real thirsty. Bloodthirsty!
Sick of waiting here.
I'll see what I can do, but don't count on it. Beat it, Wisey.
Oh, give me a break, Blousy. I bought you some flowers.
I'll see that Tallulah gets them. Oh,
quit being so smart, okay? They're for you.
Yeah, well, I gotta go.
I'll see you later.
Yeah, like 10 years later.
I've got a job.
You don't get paid for standing in a bread line now, do you?
A legit job. Soon, I'll have enough money for 2 tickets to the coast and Hollywood. Who knows? They're always looking for new stars.
Yeah, sure. I'll believe it when I see it.
2 minutes, everybody.
I really have to go.
Look, Blousy. Trust me.
Yeah.
I know. Never trust a guy who says trust me. But I was on the level. Honest, I was. I wanted to buy the tickets, but first, I had to earn the $200 driving Sam and Looney. Looney Bagonzi. Boy. When they said he was off his trolley, they weren't kidding. Me.
Driver. Boy, Loney! Loney!
It's Loney!
Keep Keep your head down, right? Wait for the okay.
What can I do for you, Sam?
Not about a small dose of straight talk, Dan.
Suits me.
You've been taking liberties, Dan.
I've been taking what's mine.
You've been taking liberties, Dan.
I've been taking what's mine.
You've been taking liberties, Dan.
I've been taking
and
what's
mine. And the trouble is, it belongs to me.
Too bad. This is not except the law, Sam.
Well, you bun your lip, mister. I'm sure we can talk things over sensibly. We've been in this game a long time, you and me. And after all, I'm a businessman.
You're a dime a dozen gangsters, Sam.
Now keep your wife clutching in your teeth, mister. I have some respect.
You slit your own throat for 2 bits plus time.
I've warned you already. Just keep them behind your teeth.
Keep talking.
I have a position to think of.
Right now, your position ain't worth a blurb, nickel.
Oh, you dirty rat, Dan.
You've been watching too many movies, Sam.
Okay, Looney, let him have
let
it.
Let go!
Quick, Bugsy, get him! Get him there! Come back here, you damn it, gangster! Go faster, Bugsy, hurry up!
Thank you.
for you, honey. Lousy, it's for you. I think it's Bugsy. Give him my love. Hello?
Hey, Bugsy. It's Bugsy.
Where are you?
Around. Listen, I can't talk to you right now, but I've just made 200 bucks.
You mean you printed it yourself?
Nah, I earned it. Swear to God.
Doing what?
This and that.
Oh yeah? Who for?
Fat Sam.
Fat Sam gave you $200?
And a loan of Easter Dan for the afternoon.
I don't believe you. You're putting me on.
Look, you get yourself outside the Grand Slam in 10 minutes, look for the snazzy sedan with a good-looking driver, and you'll find he has a very close resemblance to yours truly. Okay?
Okay. But you better not be putting me on, Buster.
Cross my heart, it's on the level. So long.
Dave Blousy?
Sort of.
I'm giving up on guys. They're nothing but trouble, believe me. From now on, I'm looking for husbands. And I ain't getting too attached. I'm gonna change them real regular. Like a Labrador. Anyway, what do you think of the dress, Tilly?
Oh, I don't know. It's kind of pink.
Come on, Dottie, what do you think?
I don't know. Maybe it's just white. Maybe the color's wrong.
What are you talking about? It's pink. I always wear pink.
Yeah, it matches the spot on your nose.
Where?
Well, maybe it's the lip.
It's the latest length. I read it in a magazine.
Maybe it's the frills. They stick out too much.
Yeah, they match your ears.
You think I'll look any better on you?
You'll probably look better on a horse.
Can I help it if my lips are ahead of my time?
They're what?
Full of personality. Character. Kind of earthy.
Yeah, like a bucket of mud.
$98.10. I just bought 2 hot dogs.
You didn't do anything crooked, did you?
Nah, of course not. I got it for driving and helping Sam out of a little predicament. Oh yeah, I nearly forgot.
What's this? A finger bowl?
It's a present, Wisey.
For me?
I didn't buy it for the audience.
Oh, Bugsy, it's great. It's really fantastic. Just tell me what it is.
It's a viewer, dummy. Look. Towing the handle. All the Hollywood stars like Charlie Chaplin, Clark Gable, Fred Astaire, and Ginger Rogers. And the one and only, Blousy Brown!
If only I could get to Hollywood.
You can.
Oh yeah, I played that one. On the front row of the Roxy Theater on East 38th Street.
Nah, rarely get to Hollywood. You want me to leave?
No, keep talking.
I got $198 left, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, what does that buy?
440 hot dogs.
No. 2 tickets, stupid.
2 tickets?
I'm super cheap.
What's the super cheap?
The train, dummy, to Hollywood. Think about it. So what's the answer?
Bugsy, did you think it'd be anything but yes? Hollywood!
Now get off, will ya?
You're putting me on.
Nah, it's just, if I don't get the sedan back to Fat Sam soon, he'll have my face looking like a plate for the yesterday's spaghetti.
Bugsy? this time, Captain Trotsky?
I have? I mean, what do you see? Tell me, O'Dreary, what do you see? Your foot, Captain! Not my foot, knucklehead! Under my foot! Tire marks!
Oh, it's a tire mark, Captain! Definitely a tire mark!
Too right, it's a tire mark, you Irish potato head! Go get some plaster! We'll take a mold! There ought to be more marks. There sure is XXX with more than one sedan around here. Hey, what's this? Gee, Captain.
I'm sorry. I didn't see you there. Honestly, I didn't.
You dumb. Potato face, Irish jerk!
Couldn't help it, Captain. It was an accident. Honestly, it was.
If I catch you, O'Dreary, I'm gonna punch that stupid Irish nose of yours right back to Tipperary!
Knuckles, hurry up out there!
Come here, boss.
Don't do that, Knuckles!
Come here, boss. I'm holding something.
But don't do it anyway. It makes me nervous. Right.
Ready, boss?
Think it's gonna work, Knuckles? I do.
But it doesn't look like a Spanish gun, boss.
Yes, it does, Knuckles. Doesn't it?
No. Yes, no. It does, boss.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, boss, it does.
Anything Danny Yang can do, Fat Sam can do better. Am I right or am I right?
You're right, boss.
Now, take aim. Ready?
Wait, boss.
Set.
Set, boss.
And...
See from the mess here, things are looking kind of untidy in Fat Sam's life. And as for Knuckles, well, whatever game it was he was playing, he sure cashed his chips in. And as for Captain Schmolsky, well, he started out with the intention of chasing old Drury back to County Cup, except he forgot he had quick drying plaster poured all over it. Pretty soon, it was looking like some of those dudes he'd occasionally dragged out of East River. Anyway. Hello?
Hello? Is there anybody there? You hurt.
Let's go, boys!
$200, that's 90 cents. It sure was nice of you to help me like that.
No, it was nothing.
You must be a fighter, right?
No.
You're not? That's the best punching I've ever seen.
No, it was nothing.
You ever been coached?
No.
You ever thought of taking it up, I mean, professionally?
No.
You haven't?
Never had a chance.
I know somebody who could help you. You know KG Joe?
Nope.
You must know Sluggers Joe.
Nope.
You don't know much, do you?
Nope.
Put it there, boy. You got yourself a manager. Hi, KG Joe.
Hi, Bugsy. Hi, me, Beth.
Swell, KG Joe. Real swell. And you?
Me? Yeah. This bunch of hunchbacks, the pits.
KG Joe, I'd like you to meet the next heavyweight champion. Leroy Smith, meet KG Joe.
Hi, Leroy. Ever been in the ring before, boy?
Nope.
Just want to be a fighter, huh?
Nope.
Sure he does. Just look at those mitts. Did you ever see such shallow eyes? Hit it, Leroy.
What's your name again, kid?
Leroy Smith.
With you showing in the ropes, KG Joe, he could be a champion in no time.
Okay, I'll try him. But it'll be no good unless he's got it.
What's it?
It's the difference between being a no-hope slugger and a champion.
That's what makes the fighter special. If you haven't got it, you just haven't got it.
Wrong.
still.
It got to the still? Not the sarsaparilla racket.
It's gone, boss. They got it. They had access and chopped away at the barrel. It's gone, drained away. Every last drop.
Oh, no. Pickett, will you get around here right away?
I can't, boss. I'm all tied up.
I don't care how busy you are. Just get around here right now. Hello? What? Not the grocery racket as well. Okay, I'm sure you did all you could. Go home and get washed up. The whole empire gone, honey. You hear me? They'll be coming here next. There's only one thing for it. You'll have to get him to help me.
Who, the Long Ranger?
Not the Long Ranger, you dumb Dora! Bugsy Malone, call him! I'm in trouble, real trouble, and all I got for coming is a female comedian.
Honey, there's no answer.
I want you to go ask for his help. Poisonally.
Poisonally?
Watch my phone, will ya? Poisonally.
Poisonally. So long, lover boy.
Tallulah.
I like my men at my feet.
What are you doing here, Tallulah?
Put your flags down, Tiger, as you take off. I got a message for you.
So what's wrong with the Western Union?
Don't flatter yourself, Tiger. It's Beth Sam wants to see you, not me. Come on, let's go before you suspend about strangles you.
I'm waiting for someone.
You are?
The Blousy. You're going to Hollywood.
Well, you know what they say. Don't pack anything you can't plan on train home. Sam's in trouble, Bugsy. I'm sure he'll see you're okay.
I'll be right there.
Perhaps?
No, boss, just a flower.
Oh, my flower. Oh, yeah, it is kind of droopy, ain't it?
Yeah, boss, a little.
In fact, it's very droopy.
Yeah, boss, very droopy.
Here, hold it for me a minute. I think it needs a little water. Now, don't you ever let me catch you laughing at me like that again, you hear me? I'm Fat Sam, top dog, Mr. Big. And if you smile at me ever again, I'll ram a damn smile down your throat. And don't you ever forget who I am, okay? I'm Fat Sam. Always have been, and always will be. What do you think I'm gonna...
Careful, boss, the floor's wet.
Oh, you no-good prune pussy goofer. If I ever get you, I'm gonna ram that damn prune down your throat. Bugsy! Hi, how you been, man?
Fine, Mr. Sicello. And you?
Oh, a little trouble at the moment, Bugsy. Come, please, take a seat. Call me Sam. Tallulah, honey, go fix him a drink, will ya?
Sure. Much a pleasure, Bugsy.
It's fresh on the rocks, maybe.
Bugsy, I'm in a real jam. Danny Dan's breathing down my neck, and any minute now, he'll be taking over my entire organization.
But you still got all this.
Not if Danny Dan gets his way. I won't have a dime for shoe shine.
Nothing?
Not a red cent.
There you go, Bugsy. One special on the run.
Thanks, Tallulah.
Tallulah, go fix your makeup or something, honey.
I've already fixed it.
And go make yourself even cleaner than you already are.
Oh, but you know that's impossible.
Tallulah, no!
Okay, I'll come out of here with my gloves.
Bugsy, I'm in a real fix. My gang's gone. My friends don't want to know me. This place ain't worth a hill of beans. Sure, Bugsy, I'm a wreck. And I need you.
Me, Sam? But why me?
Because you're no mug. You got brains up here, not pretzels.
Nah, rough stuff ain't my line.
You help me out, I'll give you $200 to go with the $200 I gave you already.
Impossible.
Impossible? I thought you were smart.
Impossible, because I already lost the hoist $200.
You lost $200 on a hoist?
Nah, I was mugged.
Too many dishonest people around these days, Bugsy. Who'd make safe walking the streets? You help me out. It's $200 that you lost, and $200 for this job.
$400.
Do we have a deal? Well,
we have a deal.
Hello?
Can I ask back again, please?
Yeah, hold on, I'll get it for you, honey. Bugsy, it's for you. I think it's lousy.
1 minute, Sam.
Sure. Take it in my office. Take the phone anywhere. Phone home. Phone Europe. Phone anywhere. After all, if Danny Dan does take over this place, it'll be him paying the phone bill, not me.
Hello, Blousy.
Blousy, is that you? What are you doing now? We said 8:30 and you're already an hour late.
Something's come up.
Like what?
Like business.
With Tallulah?
Nah, not with Tallulah, Wising.
Did you get the tickets?
No, I told you. Something's come up.
But you promised me, Bugsy.
I know. But I told you, something's come up. And this is business. It can't wait. Hollywood can.
An hour I've been waiting here, Bugsy. When you first didn't show, I gave you the benefit of the doubt. Then I got nervous and I called every single pool hole dive in the phone book. They hadn't seen you before, did they know you?
Now get off, Tallulah.
You rat! You two-timing bog Irish meatball!
Bugsy.
Lousy.
Broads, they're nothing but trouble.
Oh, me a fool.
Oh,
Leroy! Hey, Leroy! Wake up! Come on! Leroy!
Who is it?
What's wrong? It's me, Leroy. Bugsy. Come on, get dressed. We got a job.
You got me equipped for the job already?
Nah, this is a different kind of job.
I'm tired, Bugsy. Come back in the morning.
Be too late in the morning. You'll be working for Fat Sam's the Channel. You'll be hitting Dandy down where it hurts. And the... And there's $200 in it for you.
I'll do it!
Guys, this place is like a morgue. Let's have a little optimism here. We're not on top of the hill yet. How about some music? Oh, hi, Blousey. Good to see you. I thought you was on your way to the coast.
It kind of fell through.
Oh, shame.
Mr. Stichello, do you think I can have my job back, please?
Sure, honey. The more the merrier. Go straight in.
Hey, Blousey.
What happened? Did you miss your train?
What's wrong? You got your job?
Don't worry, Blousey. Lousy,
how you been? Get your bra turned up so high.
Yeah, the Statue of Liberty.
No good just the two of us, Leroy. What are we gonna do?
Go home!
We need an army to get through.
No army right here, Bugsy!
Stop!
What's wrong?
Listen!
Time you waste when time's a precious thing to live for.
the bottom, but remember you'll be building from the ground up. And every day's another step that makes you even closer to the sky. So give it a try. Sail away, you missed the boat and found that you've been left behind. Firelight some more until you know the world is ready to receive you. A lady luck is before, but a lady is allowed to change her mind. Come on, what's the matter with you?
Give this a baby face.
No thanks.
No thanks.
No thanks, brother.
No thanks.
Face, you get out there.
Okay. I've got to have courage. Courage. Just think. I'm the star of this show right now. Star of Storm. Okay.
Gotta be quick.
Gotta be sick.
gone to sleep.
Got to be the best.
Best.
Shouldn't have any trouble. Just Sam and a few dance old girls. Remember, you get inside the speakeasy, keep those things pumping. You can be history moving right.
Three cheers for Dan down. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Too kind, guys, too kind. Now, that's Sam's flying slap.
Gee, Patty, you think you can stand for us?
Okay, bye.
wonderful. Absolutely wonderful.
What you've seen tonight is the culmination of lots and lots of hard work by everybody. Not only the cast and the musicians, but all those people behind the scenes, a myriad of them. And obviously it's too many people to mention, but I must mention one or two. One is Phil Jameson. Woo! Got them into shape in that field. This is great. Yeah! And finally, if it hadn't been for Jason, Rhys Jones and Stephen Cleary, I don't think we would really have been able to put this performance on.
without saying a big thank you to all the staff who are involved.
Mr. Jameson, would you like to come back down, please? It's all right.
Mr. Jameson!
Okay, Mrs. Weeper, could you come back down?
Yeah!
Just don't see the people behind the cast.
Come on, Gary.
Come on, Gary.